morning.
Good morning. Good morning. You may be seated. Please make certain your cell phone is off or quiet. I will do the same, because mine would be the one that would ring. Good morning.
Good morning.
Well, that was a pretty good welcome. Good morning.
Good morning.
Hello, church. I'm going to invite you to pray with me. Wasn't that song amazing? I love the lyrics of this song. Not there, not there. Where is it?
Spirit alive in us.
Spirit, you're alive in us. You're alive in us right here. Right here and now. In the most powerful way. Do you feel the energy in the room? That energy is love. And I'm going to talk about love and strength today in my talk. But that this idea, Spirit, you're the breath in us. You're the grace in us. You're the peace in us. You're the power in us. That is the truth for us today. Pray with me, gracious and loving God. We take a moment now to consciously open our hearts and minds to the movement of your Spirit and to each other. God, we trust and know that you are now pouring yourself in us, through us, as us. Lift us higher. Thank you, God. Amen. And please join me. I'm Ric Beattie. I'm the minister here, senior minister. And we welcome you, and we welcome those of you who are online right now on Facebook, and those who will watch the archives later. We're like three groups of people now. Doggone pandemic. So did you love the fact that there was frost this morning?
No.
Oh, my goodness. Diana Grady, it's good to see you back there. And we want to wish Jennifer and Sharon a happy six-year anniversary. 6 years ago today, the 24th. I had the great joy of officiating their legal marriage. I had done a holy union for them prior, so it was a wonderful thing. I want you to join me in our statement of being. Think about the words as you say them. This is a powerful statement of truth. God is all, both invisible and visible. One presence, one mind, one power is all. This one that is all is perfect life, perfect love, and perfect substance. I am an individualized expression of God. I am ever one with this perfect life, perfect love, and perfect substance. And so it is. Amen. And you know, if I am one with God, that means everybody is. Sometimes it's easy to forget that. Sometimes stuff gets in the way. This Saturday, we will gather, our prayer partners are hosting, we gather to remember, a time of remembrance at 1:00 in the afternoon. It's going to be a time to honor all those who have passed, to honor the things that we're grieving, to honor the dear ones that are not here anymore. It's not too late to add a name to that list. You can do it on our website, unityofroyaloak.org. See the picture that looks like this one? Click on it. It'll take you to a form. And I added the memorial service I did yesterday for a woman who would have been 36 on Friday, who took she died by suicide in February. Her parents have been waiting till it was close to her birthday. Someone said to me, Rick, how can you do those things? I say, how can I not? Those are my gifts. Those are my gifts. And I didn't realize that this young woman's brother has been here several times. So it was good and it was tough and we cried. Sometimes we do all of it, don't we? So Saturday at 1:00, a time of remembrance. It's powerful. Oh, yeah, thanks, Mary. Yes, if you bring a photo, we'll have a, you can say a bit about that. The photo, tell us why it's important to you. We're probably going to stream it. We'll configure ourselves in semicircles, and we'll just stream it out to Facebook because that's all we can do live. I think it's going to be a powerful experience. I know that I have plenty of stuff that I'm grieving, layers and layers of grief. I talked to Mary about it a few months ago. She encouraged me to make a list. Mary, that list is a lot longer than I ever thought it would be. Absolutely. No, I just have a cold. Everybody in my house has a cold. We also have our Thanksgiving outreach. Outreach is doing a bang-up thing for Thanksgiving. Laura, how many people are you serving at the transitional housing unit? 42 people are going to get a meal. Yay. And we will see if the Royal Oak Schools has anybody they would like to get us to provide meals for. And if there's anyone in the community, please let one of us know that you know somebody in need, and we will address that. Okay. If you were here last Sunday, at the end of my talk, I shared some startling news that I was about to retire in a month. That was not a knee jerk. It was more a straw that broke the camel's back thing. First of all, I'm not going to retire, so take a breath. In the most amazing way that Spirit works, even the title of my talk today, which is Love is Still the Answer, right? It's still the answer. And sometimes we just push up against it. And I offer this not as an excuse, because what I did was inappropriate to do it in public. Our code of ethics talks about and it's supposed to be for all leaders, including the board, that we work together, we find a way, and if we can't find a way forward, we have a process that involves Unity Worldwide Ministries and or our regional rep. I'm not going to air our laundry here. What I do know is that the board and I, well, let me back up. I woke up Monday morning really early, like, oh, dang. Not with regret, because I thought about it. I was leaving. I've applied for Social Security, activated my pension from Northrop, and I was exhausted, and I'm still exhausted. But throwing the board under the bus, even though we have some issues we got to work on, throwing the board under the bus in public is not the way. I get that. I own my part in that. It's always been for you. My commitment has always been to you that I will be as real as I can be and as authentic as I can be. There's another part of our code of ethics that talks about self-care. And I have been, this has been a year of big lessons on self-care. Some of you know that I took a road trip in July, drove to Cleveland and then drove to Nashville. I experienced panic attacks and waves of anxiety like I've never done. Please understand that in March of 2019, when I entered the field program, I have been at a dead push since then until my ordination. On top of that, we're in a pandemic that won't seem to go away and leave us alone. And one of the things that I learned on that road trip was that I can't push the way I used to. It doesn't matter how much I want to. I've also learned that lesson here. I cannot push. And I'm not interested at this point in my life. I'm going to be 66 in less than a month. In pushing and pushing and pushing and pushing. And it isn't just the board. It's a lot. It's been a very, very stressful time. I think about how to keep us moving all the time. That's what I think about all the time. How do we continue to move forward? So Monday morning, I talked with Greg Coles, Reverend Greg Coles, our regional rep. His specialty is crisis and conflict management for churches, because churches are like a big family, and it's a dance we do. And it's been a hard dance for... and I acknowledge the board members too, hard to manage the church or your part of that process. For a long time, we weren't meeting even in person. We've not solidified the relationships. We've not done a board, any kind of leadership training that we almost do something every year, and we haven't done in a couple of years. My part in this was I let myself get bone dry, among other things, bone dry. So I am doing some things about that. But in the most interesting way that Spirit works in me and in us, I was writing a letter to the board, an email, and Navalette called me on Thursday. Now, our prayer partners have been holding the leadership team, all of us, this church, in prayer since last Tuesday. Yesterday, they had a prayer call. I wasn't a part of that. I'm part of their team, but I let them do that. I was doing a memorial service. So you see, God has been working here. And I'm mindful of Mother Teresa's statement that says if we feel disconnected, it's because we've forgotten the love that we have for each other. That takes work. And I'm committed to do the work. Reverend Greg Coles will work with us. When I get back, I'm going to take a sabbatical, much needed, because this work that I do is not like any other kind of work I've ever done. It's not just sitting at a desk typing or something. It never stops. So for 6 glorious weeks, you will not see me. But I'm going to ask you to pray for me. I'm going to ask this whole church to pray every day for this community. Because we have some serious work ahead of us. Not just getting beyond the pandemic, but how do we rebuild? How do we rebuild our volunteer ranks? How do we, because the pandemic is going to be around. I mean, I keep reading, it'll at some point not be a pandemic, it'll be an endemic. We've got to find ways to move forward together. I'm absolutely committed to doing the work that I need to do. I have spoken both with Carol and with Navalette, and we will see. It's not going to be easy. We have some issues to deal with. But there are always issues to deal with. He's just out of hand. And I think if I hadn't been so worn out, maybe it's hard. I'm not going to have conjecture. I just want you to know that the way I see myself leaving here at some point, because I will retire, I'm not going to work forever. But there's work for me here, and I'm really, really, really clear about it, more than ever, perhaps. We're drawing some new people to us. It's time for us to take another step, and it begins right now. So thank you. I apologize to this church for throwing it into crisis. It didn't have to be that way, and I get that. And I apologize to the board. What I thought had happened didn't necessarily happen the way I thought it did. Navalette assures me there was not a board meeting without me. The rest will work that out. So thank you, board, and thank you, church. Thank you, church. Now, you all know I cry really easy. Yes, Navalette, I cry. When we got off the phone, she and I, on Thursday, I said, okay, I got to go have a cry. She goes, I think I'm going to go to the ladies' room and have me one, too. I know that blows your tough image. I know that. But the other thing I know is that both Navalette and I are really skilled at digging our heels in. That's what I know. We're past that. I think that we will emerge from this time stronger. Not just the board, but the church. Sometimes it takes the crisis. Because remember, crisis and opportunity are both sides of one single coin. And our goal when I came here was to be as real as dirt. Well, stuff happens, and it did. All right, enough. I love you too. Thanks, you guys. I did what? Now, Vlad and all the board members, love them all. Love them all, yes. Give them a hand. Well, it's... We are in this together. We will be stronger together. Absolutely, I know it. We've got a youth ministry program to rebuild. April pointed out to me the other day, we have two families is all we've got going on right now. And they're getting stronger, so we're getting stronger. Oh, the other announcement that I have for you, couple. I kept wondering, why is it the city coming to inspect the roughed-in plumbing? Like, I was getting annoyed. So I got a hold of our plumber over the weekend. So, oh, dang, I forgot to go get the permit. So that'll be dealt with tomorrow. And Friday, this past Friday, I met with our electrical contractor. Finally was able to get him here. And they will get the proposal, because there's a lot of electrical stuff. Some of it related directly to the where we stopped in the kitchen, but some of it also that had been happening in here. So they'll get the price, the contract, a proposal, and I'll get it to the board right away. He said Wednesday or Thursday. So things are happening. They thought that they could start working in the kitchen area. And this could be a little bit of a dance between the carpenter contractor and the electrical contractor, because they have to build a wall and leave it open and then put the electricity in and then have it inspected, and then so it'll be a little bit back and forth. But during my absence, some stuff will start to happen, and you'll see it start to happen. So it's a powerful thing for us, too, to get this beyond us. So, yes, yes. And then, just so you know, I want you to know this is coming. About the time I get back, I'll be looking for volunteers to help come paint that whole room. So there'll be an opportunity for us together, and I'll buy the pizza, I promise. Okay. The daily word for Sunday, October the 24th is passion. I share this with you with the permission of Unity, who publishes Daily Word. My purpose fuels my passion. Say that with me. My purpose fuels my passion. Purpose sets my heart aflame with passion. Each day I awaken ready to answer the call of my heart, to give my best efforts and fullest attention to purposeful activity. Passion is the energy I bring to everything I do. I discover the glory of God through passion as I do the things that make me feel the most alive, that fill me with energy and zeal and color, the world with hope and promise. I recognize the divine presence behind it all. It's God flowing into form in us. God is the source of all the passion I feel and the purpose that drives me. My passion is not for me alone. The life energy that radiates from me inspires those around me to live a life of purpose and passion, to boldly express their divinity as only they can. And the Bible verse for today is from 1 Peter chapter 4, verse 11. Whoever speaks must do so as one speaking the very words of God. Whoever serves must do so with the strength that God supplies. It's my prayer that God write these words into our hearts in a living way. So, our prayer partners started praying yesterday. They're all praying for us. I said, who's doing it today? Kathy's all of us. So we got a bunch of them in here. And I will be, we have a really exciting, can I tell them about the 14th?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. So in the interesting way that Spirit works, because I was scheduled to speak on the 14th, a couple of days ago, Jamie Lula texted Kim and I, and he's going to be here attending to his sister and his mother, because the mom's moving back in with the daughter. And he's going to do the talk that day and the music that day. So we have Jamie Lula on the 14th. You won't want to miss it. And it's interesting to me that my time away, because I'd been hoping to push through to the end of the year before I took sabbatical. Well, no, Rick. It was just like driving down that doggone mountain in Louisville. I didn't it didn't matter. I was going to go down the mountain, and it was done. But November's power is the power of elimination and renunciation. It's time to let go of what no longer serves. And it seems like the perfect time for a deep drink at the well. Okay. So prayer partners, the entire team is praying for us. We take a moment now to get centered and settled, to take a deep breath together. Almighty and loving Spirit, God, Jesus, Buddha, Allah, all of the many names, we call upon you, who are not out there somewhere, but in us, as us. We call to mind those people, those areas, those challenges that we would like to see healed and whole. And we take a moment now to either hold them in our hearts or to speak them into the space that we currently occupy. Unity of Royal Oak. Max. The surgeries, Debbie and Zan. Mm-hmm. Our whole leadership team. God, we're open. Oh, yes, Lydia. Mm-hmm. I love the murmurs. We pray affirmatively. We pray trusting and knowing that it is God's good pleasure to give us the kingdom. So we don't doubt or hesitate. We step forward boldly. We pray for all those who serve us, the police, the fire, the first responders, the doctors, the nurses, everyone working. We pray too for everyone who's struggling in any way with depression. God, move in them that they might reach out to somebody. We know that every thought we think, every word we say, every feeling we hold, each of these is a prayer. So we take good care of what we're praying. There have not been this many people in this building in 20 months. So give yourselves a hand. Give yourselves a hand. And now, would you please join me in the Lord's Prayer? Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever and ever. Amen. And now I invite you to set aside from your laps and your minds anything that would interfere with you spending some time in communion with God, the divine source, again, not out there somewhere, within you, in your heart. And we take a moment to allow ourselves to relax. We get comfortable in our seats. We get comfortable in our own skin. Living Spirit, we know that life has no ultimate destination, for life is eternal. We are always in a time of becoming, always in a time of being drawn closer, if we're willing, to your presence, to your reality, to your truth. We let go of the struggle. And instead, we focus on what we want deeply, what makes us happy, what makes our tails wag. But we know that we are creating what we are predominantly thinking about. We know that we are the authors of the lives that we live. We allow ourselves to move deeper within our own beingness by following the next breath we take inward. When we observe our breath, it's such a great teacher. Always right on time. Each breath brings in oxygen to the system. Our lungs and heart move in an amazing way. We get oxygen to ourselves. We don't have to think about it or figure it out or even really understand it. We surrender ourselves to the mystery that is your presence. Thank you, God, for this day. And in this moment, we begin again. And so it is, always. Amen.
Whoever told you you can't win? Whoever said that if you fail, don't try again? It's in the ordinary, deep in the weak and weary, the power to overcome the fear you're holding in. You could be a hero, you could be the change in this world, rise above the normal. Have to be afraid anymore. We have a light, we have a hope, we have a love inside we're fighting for. You could be a hero. You don't have to look that hard to see. You don't have to reach that far. Find someone in need. There is a desperation deep in this generation, looking for something new, a love they can believe. You can be a hero. You can be the change in this world. Rise above the normal. Have to be afraid anymore. We are the light. We are the hope. We are the love inside worth fighting for. You could lead. You could be. Love will even cross the ocean wide. Love will lose its all to save a life. Because of the love God gave, you'll find. You could be a hero. You could change the state of this world. Rise above the normal. Don't have to be afraid anymore. We are the light. We are the hope. We are the love inside worth fighting for. You could be, you could be, you could be a hero. You could be, you could be, you could be a hero.
Thank you, Tony Camelitti. You just have the perfect voice for that song and the one coming up afterwards. I'm so glad you're here. You could be a hero. Yes, thank you. Thank you, Kevin, yes. But we don't always own it, do we? Have you ever looked in the mirror and said, you're a hero, I love you? Try it. Because the ultimate being hero, it has to start here. It's like loving. It has to start here. Where else can it start? How does God express that? Is that something where you've heard me talk about this 500 times, I'm sure, over the years. It isn't something out there. It's something inside of us. If each of us could really, really, really get that, we would transform this world in a moment. It wouldn't take very many of us. It wouldn't take very many. So, love is still the answer. Like, God knew that I had put this talk for this day, I did it a month ago. Love is still the answer. It's always the answer. It's got to start with each of us, though. Self-love, self-care. April laughs at me because it's like, she's been trying to talk to me about this stuff for a really long time. Well, here I am, Mr. By God, I can just keep going. Well, then, not only have I fallen on my face, but twice. Big, 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 big. So we're going to talk today about the light of God, the light in you as love, wisdom, and strength. We're just going to touch on some concepts because I could do a series. Each one of these is a talk. So let's first look at the metaphysical meaning of love, what Mr. Fillmore wrote in Revealing Word. Love is the pure essence of being that binds together the whole human family. Think about that. Now think about the ones that you don't like. You are bound to them. Nothing you can do about it. That's the struggle, isn't it? We're bound together. We don't always know how to dance without stepping on each other's feet. Divine love is impersonal. It loves for the sake of loving. Not because you're going to get something in return. Human beings do that. We've all seen them do it. I see it with Owen sometimes. He gets all sweet when he wants something from his mother. And then when he doesn't get it, he throws himself on the floor and has a tantrum. There it is, the beginning of it all, right there. It's got a place in us, got a hold in us, a hook in us. And I love this quote. I'd never heard this. Don't remember it anyway. Charles Fillmore wrote in Jesus Christ Heals, and I want you to just take this in, and your mind's going to want to fight with it, maybe. God does not love anybody or anything. God doesn't, we say it, don't we? Oh, God loves you. Oh, God loves you. Bless your heart. God is the love in everybody. Huge difference. God doesn't love you. God is love in you. Because God isn't out there. God is here. The energy, the very life in us. God is love. People become loving by permitting that which God is to find expression in word and act. So when we say God loves somebody, that means that I love you. You have to, it's you. You're blessing them. God loves you because I love you. Behold it. See it. Love is an inner quality that sees good everywhere and in everybody. Take a deep breath. Who just popped into your head? Everybody. Love is the great harmonizer and healer. Whoever calls on God as Holy Spirit for healing is calling upon divine love. How often we talk about healing. Healing body, mind, and spirit. We need them all, right? This whole world is very fragile. Have you noticed how it's affected us all? It's fragile and it's not. It's fragile and it's not. But it's changed us all. It's changed us all. Love, therefore, is the fulfillment of the law, Romans 13:10 says. Love is the fulfillment of the law. What's the law? To love each other. Love one another as I've loved you. To bring peace, which starts in us. Let's have a look quick at wisdom. I took up a lot of time, you know me, when I just start talking about stuff. And you know, things aren't going to change. I've been here 7 years and 8 months. It's, what you get is what you get. I'd be hoping to be better all the time. Wisdom is the intuitive knowing. Wisdom is intuitive knowing. Wisdom isn't knowledge. Knowledge is the intellect. You can learn stuff. God knows I learned a whole lot of stuff to get through my field program that I will probably never remember again. But intuition is that place where God speaks in us, to us, in our consciousness. It is the voice of God within as the source of our understanding. Why do you think I talk so often about spiritual practice? What's your spiritual practice? And there are many. I know some of you, and I know what are some of the things that you do. I switch mine up every once in a while. I change things. Get in a rut. It's easy to get in a rut. Just doing the same thing. It's kind of like always singing the peace song or always saying the Lord's Prayer. One of these days I'm going to shock you. I'm going to do something different there. I'm warning you now. That's why we develop. That's why we spend time in meditation. That's why I walk. I know that some of my practices have gotten threadbare. I'm going to spend 6 weeks walking and meditating and listening to music and going to a movie. And it begins with a retreat with Martha Creek. April and I are going to be down. I'm not driving all that way by myself. We're going to do it together. We'll go together. Well, there are lots of places I'm good to drive as long as it's flat and straight. I just don't want to drive in Indianapolis or Louisville. We'll work it out. We're good travel companions. Until I get sleepy, right? I'm in this place. I'm just going to let it all hang out. It's the way of it. Wisdom includes judgment, discrimination, intuition, and all the departments of mind that come under the head of knowing. Knowing. This knowing capacity transcends intellectual knowledge. There's something more. There's something bigger. There's more to you and me. That more, we call it the I am. We call it the Christ. We call it God. We call it our divine self. Has lots of names. Doesn't matter what name you call it, how you connect with it. So we have this idea of love, which is the great harmonizing, balancing, binding force in the universe. And wisdom, which is our ability to understand, to discern the voice of God within us. And then strength, because these are these, and I'm doing roughly, I'm using Reverend Linda Martella Whitsett's book, Divine Audacity. Do you dare to be the light of the world? That's the series. Are you willing to be the light of the world? Yeah, thank you. At least one. Might like it. Light the fire. Strength is the energy of God. Think about that for a moment. Think about the energy that creates worlds, that holds the planets in their places. That energy is in you as strength. Now, that's not just physical strength. Strength is in body, mind, and spirit, all of them. I'm not nearly as strong now as I was. It annoys the snot out of me. There are things that I just cannot do anymore. There are things I have to ask my 32-year-old niece to do at home. She'll gently say, "Let me give you a hand, Uncle Rick." He's like, "Okay." She just says, "That's really heavy." That's beyond that. There is in you strength. But all of these things, love, wisdom, strength, are dormant unless you activate them. How do you activate them? Lots of ways. Meditate, pray, call upon them, ponder them, write about them, journal about them. There is so much more to you and to me than we have. Strength does sometimes look like asking for help. You're right. Thank you. That's why we're better as a team, because I don't have it all. I'm not going to pretend that I do. And it is probably the hardest thing I've ever done is ask for help, because of some image I had in my mind that I had to be the best little boy in the world and suck it up, buttercup. You get to a point in life where it's not possible anymore. At least I have. And it doesn't interest me either. So call upon the strength in you and trust that there's more than you've ever used. And if you need help, ask somebody to help you. It's like moving the picnic table out in the yard. I can drag it. It's much better if three of us do it together. That's why we come together as a community. We get to rehearse the great dance of life. We get to rehearse, how do we operate? How do we embody the divine presence? And how does it show up in you? And how is it different in you than it is in me? We're still learning, folks. We're still dancing. Grateful for you. Thank you, God. Amen.
Amen.
The question is why? Why are we here to say our hellos and goodbyes and then disappear?
Beautiful life, what is it for? To learn how to master peace or master war?
Answer that matters. Even if your heart has been shattered, whatever you want, whatever you are after, love is still the answer. And the question that sits on everyone's lips Because why should we pick ourselves up and start over again? There's only one.
There's only one
answer that matters.
Answer that matters.
Even if your heart has been shattered. Whatever you want, whatever you are after.
I think we've had some church up in the house today. Just saying. Ushers are going to come forward to receive the offering. If you are at home, you can contribute, or you can do it here through PayPal or Tithely on our website. We prefer Tithely, but either way, checks are good. Drop them in the mail slot. Just don't put them in the book nook. That's happened before. And I want to just say that part of the work ahead of us, and I'm going to encourage you during my absence while I'm sabbatical, to keep faithful with your giving, because we're about to launch to finish this project up. We're going to spend money, and part of what I need going forward is a business person here to work with me. So just hold that image for me, and because I believe that God is the source, we'll find the way, the board and I will find the way to make that happen. So take your gift in your hand or hold an image of it in your mind. Let's say the blessing together. Divine love, through me, blesses and multiplies all that I have, all that I give, and all that I receive. God, we open our hearts and our minds up to give, and we receive as we give, and so it is. Amen. Join me as we bless these gifts. And not just these gifts, but everything that everybody does. Laura came last night and covered up our flowers because she's going to keep them alive and take them in. the singer, the choir sings, so many ways that people give. God, we give thanks for the gifts and the givers. We bless them all. We bless the gifts that you have given us. We are open to being good stewards. Thank you. And so it is. Amen. Whatever you've got going on this week, remember that the light of God surrounds us. The love of God enfolds us. The power of God protects us and watches over us. Wherever we are, God is. All is well. Have a great week.
Amen.